Okay, hello again. Now in this next video, what I'd like to go over is how there might be some multiple shapes here of the aggregate supply curve. We've been drawing it as just a straight line, but it probably isn't just a straight line. So I'll put, here's the model, inflation on the vertical axis, output. The long run aggregate supply curve is vertical at potential output. But you know, we've drawn this as just a straight line for convenience. But in all practicality, it may be very difficult to go too much past potential output. We might be able to go out past it a little bit for a short period of time, but it's not sustainable. I mean, we could increase GDP real quickly, double GDP by having everyone work 80 hours a week instead of 40 hours a week, but it's not sustainable. So how far can we really go past this potential output? So it might be that maybe right here, we run into some sort of wall that we really can't get past. Given our technology and the production function and how many people we have, we just can't produce any more than that. So it's quite possible here that way down here in this early range of output, this aggregate supply curve might be pretty flat. And then it will start to increase as we get closer to potential. And then as we go past potential, it might be running up against some sort of wall that we really can't get past. So the short run aggregate supply curve could look something like this, where flat down in the low ranges of GDP and vertical up at the higher ranges. Now this is important because if aggregate demand is down here, we're in a recession and we have some sort of fiscal policy to increase aggregate demand, we might be able to increase output substantially here without inflation going up very much. So we can increase output, but just a little tiny bit of an increase inflation if it's pretty flat. But if we're at full employment, if aggregate demand is right here, the intersection's at full employment, and we have some sort of fiscal policy, some tax cut or increase in GDP by the same amount, I'll try to draw it by the same amount here. Increase in aggregate demand. You can see that the increase in output isn't going to be as much. So there'll only be this much of an increase in output, but the effect on prices or inflation would be a whole lot more. So how much output is going to increase and how much inflation is going to increase really depends on the shape of this aggregate supply curve and where we are. If it's at some point where it's kind of vertical, then an increase in aggregate demand won't have a whole lot of effect on output. It'll just change the inflation rate. But if we're way back at, say, a recession that's far left of output inside the PPF, then fortunately, an increase in aggregate demand might have a bigger effect on output without increasing prices a whole lot.